Good afternoon, everyone. A warm welcome to this special session, which is titled IELTS Preparatory, Ask the Experts. Respected Dean Sir, my esteemed colleagues, the trainers for IELTS, and the IELTS achiever, Karthik. I'm Samir Das, Deputy Director, School of Language. In fact, all of you want to dream big. All of you dream big. You want to fly high, fly beyond the horizon, fly across globally. We are here to strengthen your wings. Our honorable founder, sir, Dr. Achyuta Samanta, always used to say, if you are a performer, then sky is the limit. So that's why we chose this background. The horizon is within your limit. If you can perform. IELTS, International English Language Testing System, is a dream for you to have access to the global companies. In fact, if you crack the exam, you will be welcomed in 10,000 countries, 10,000 plus countries in 150 countries, more than 150 countries. That is the kind of a reach this examination is having. But the most important is how to prepare. You need a handholding, a proper coach who can guide you to go through this examination process and get good score. For that, we have conducted this special session for you all so that you know the technicalities of IELTS preparation. And we have with us a very distinguished trainer who are British Council certified trainers in IELTS from Bangalore, Ms. Suchismita Bastia and Ms. Amrita Chutra. And we have also an IELTS academic achiever, Mr. Karthik, who is a mechanical engineering student. Before I give them this opportunity to make their presentation, I would request our Honorable Dean Sir, Dr. Biswajit Das, Dean Keats School of Languages, to give his welcome remark. Over to you, sir.
Very good evening. Namaskar. Welcome to everybody, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Mr. Samir Kumar Das, Deputy Director. I welcome everybody on behalf of the School of Languages for the course IELTS, for the Proficiency Certificate course that has been floated with the help and support of our esteemed Amrita Chotra Madam, our Suchismita Madam, of which Karthik stands as a testimony to be, as one who is an IELTS achiever. He, being a student of our university in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, within a short stint of time, has accomplished by virtue of his self-discipline and understanding, having been guided by Amrita Madam and Suchismita Madam to accomplish the destination. The score that he has achieved has been proved to the destination, meaning I thought every step that he was wanting to stride was escorted by ma'am to make sure that he accomplishes the target. That's what I was thinking like in one sense. And the platform that has been created is intended for all of you to chisel and sharpen your ideas to make sure that you ensure that you accomplish that of your ambition to score better marks in IELTS, to go beyond borders, to go international, to go overseas, to make sure that you study across 150 countries. This is not very difficult until you are not equipped with those kind of ideas which are required of you. Like for instance, let's say, if you are having those techniques of martial art, you can well defend yourself with little bit of energy in you, the power that you would have. But what is required is the skill. So I truly believe that if you pursue this course, evidently you'll be able to succeed in accomplishing those worth marks, bandwidth at which you need to score. Thereby, you get a perch somewhere in the international university, somewhere for going abroad for, you know, job and all those aspects. So I believe you join in large number on the benefit of the platform that is there in your university. Many universities don't have, even in Bhubaneswar we don't have. Though things are online, and this point of time, it is the right time that you can explore the possibility and explore your potential to, you know, get admitted into a top-notch school for your advanced studies or for job for that matter. But for IELTS, TOEFL is little harder, as you know. IELTS, it will be very, very easy for you, and you can reach to any of the countries. Any of the countries for your higher studies, any of the countries for your job, whatever be there. With these very words, I would think I just hand over to our Deputy Director, sir. And I think all of you join the course and make your target worthwhile, you know, to accomplish that of the objective that you have set for. Thank you very much. Best wishes to all of you.
Thank you, Dean, sir, for your encouraging words. Now I would, in fact, we, as I said, Suchismith and Amrita are very accomplished corporate trainer with having more than 15 years of experience in dealing with academics and corporate in many parts of India. So here today I'm opening the session, the panel discussion, online panel discussion, by inviting Amrita Chotra to convene in the session, and after that there will be question and answer. Okay, Amitana, please.
Thank you, Sameer sir. Thank you. Thank you, Dean sir, for your encouraging words. And I welcome Suchismita and Karthik to join me in this discussion. Meanwhile, a few things. I would welcome all the participants today to ask whatever queries they have, anything they would like to know about IELTS, you are most welcome. And also, if you want information about KSOL IELTS, also, you're most welcome. So we will start this with a discussion. But as and when, if there are questions from the audience, please do not hesitate to put it in the chat box.
Madam, sorry, I have disabled the chat box at the moment. Let the panel discussion get over. Then after that, I'll open the chat box as well as the unmute option.
Okay,
let
fine.
The discussion happen.
Fine. Okay, we can do that. So yes, we'll start with the discussion. And all of you can put your queries at the end of the discussion. Okay, if the question is left unanswered, you feel there is something you would want us to guide you with, please do not hesitate to ask. And we will be very happy to oblige you with the answer that we are aware of. So I would now like to share my screen with all of you. I hope it's visible. Suchi, is the screen visible? Could you please confirm?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible. Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Yes, so IELTS, what we call the world speaks IELTS. That's the tagline. Yes. Today in this century, and apart from the pandemic, which has been in news for such a long time, now, something that has never stopped and will not stop in future, that is the upgradation of one's skills. Wherever we are always expected to move on. So whether I am in a particular job, whether I'm a student, whether I'm somebody who's aspiring for a career overseas, I will be, you know, eager and anxious to know about what opportunities do I have. So IELTS is the gateway to those opportunities. It is English for international opportunity. We call it English for international opportunity. Now, the discussion is about IELTS. So we'll start with the full form of IELTS. As many of you are already aware, and some of you would like to know it once again, IELTS stands for International English Language Testing System. English is missing over here in the slide, but yes, that is the most important part, International English Language Testing System. Okay. It is a standardized test of English language proficiency, and it is not testing any other language, but definitively English language. Now here, many of you can come, why only English? I think that question has long been answered, whether it is your language of a medium of instruction, your language of education, or your language of conversation with international audience, language of presentation, or any kind of language that we have so far been operating with, or we have needed so far, happens to be English. So even if I'm a non-native speaker and I aspire to go to a country where English becomes the native language, I am expected either to take up a job or I go for my higher studies over there. So whatever it is, I'm expected to talk in English. If my lecturer is talking to me, I'm expected to understand his English. Even if I speak Indian English, my lecturer or professor would be speaking in American, British, or Australian English. So I must have a listening ability and a comprehension ability of those accents as well. So that's why a minimum requirement of English is compulsory anywhere outside India when we want to go for a job or a career or higher studies or just for migration. We want to go so that, you know, our children get a better opportunity outside. So for whatever reasons, if I want to go abroad for my studies, I will be asked about my score in IELTS. It's a standardized international test. It was established in 1989. Okay, for your information, this is, you know, it started long back. And jointly, it is managed by these three organizations, IDP Australia, British Council, okay, and Cambridge Assessment. So Cambridge is the what we call materials partner. They design the test, and it is not like one or two people. They have a panel which sits and writes these kind of tests, frames these questions. And believe me, none of the tests has ever been repeated. No, that is the kind of intellectual pool they have, and they put all their resources into this to prepare test which is comprehensive and understandable all over the world, where students all over the world can understand and take the test. And it's a standardized thing so that everybody can be, you know, assessed at the regular parameters. It is not like for one area, it is only English, it is only listening, or for one country, it is only reading, nothing like that. It's equalized, and it is a great equalizer. This test, we call it as a great equalizer among all nationalities today. One of the major English language tests in the world, this happens to be one of the major English tests. It is accepted by most, or almost all, I can say today. That is 10,000. The number of universities which accept is 10,000, quite a huge number of universities. American, Australian, British, Canadian, New Zealand, all academic institutions and professional organizations across the world. Even if you have a job, which most of the doctors, nurses, engineers, MBAs, they already do, but they want to migrate and they want to have a career overseas and you know, at least work for 10, 20 years and then come back. At that time also, it is very important that they prepare for the IELTS and take the test. So apart from their academic competency, because of which they'll be hired, but until unless they clear the IELTS, they will be taking the IELTS test until unless they have a score which is accepted in that country. So why take IELTS? Okay, I just answered that. Work, live, study in an English speaking country, a dream of each one of us at some point or the other. You must be able to demonstrate a high level of language ability. English is the third most spoken language in the world, with 379 million speaking it worldwide today. Okay. And I often say that, you know, we cannot manage without English these days. We have to learn. If I know a foreign language apart from English, very good. That's an added advantage. But it is not like if I know only a foreign language and do not know English, it's not going to help me. I need my English. Along with that, I can have a foreign language to top it up, like cake, icing on the cake. So being able to communicate in native language of the country you wish, you know, to study and you wish to acquire a wide range of benefits, which is only possible through this particular test, that is IELTS, and essential for job opportunities as well as integration into the community. Often it is seen, even in schools, you see kids. If there is a group of kids which communicates better, then they there is another student who is not able to communicate as well. Most of the time you see there is a clear demarcation that he is not welcomed into this group because the person is not able to talk or share or communicate properly. So we feel out of the community. So the world is nothing but a bigger group. So when I go out of my high school, I go out of my college, I go out of my country, so I will go and get into a group where the food habits, the language, the lifestyle, the cultural diversity, the festivals, everything is different. So over there, I need inclusion into the community. I need to get included into the community. IELTS is my gateway. IELTS takes me there, okay? Globally recognized by more than 10,000 employers, universities, schools, and immigration bodies, including 3,400 institutions in the USA alone. It is only in USA 3,400. So imagine the number worldwide. What IELTS score do I need? Higher the better. It is always better. So IELTS has a 9 band score. It is 0 to 9. When we go further into the discussion, because I'm just giving you a small intro, the discussion, we will have it in a while. So when we go further into it, we'll discuss about how the score is required and what does a higher score or a more acceptable score looks like. We'll see that. Each immigration body, university, workplace, or institute will have their own specific IELTS score. Yes, this is important because some are okay if you score a 6.5 and you are a trained nurse, you have been working as a nurse in your country, in your home country for some time, but you want to go into another country where English is being spoken because the salaries are also higher there and the experience over there will will take you a notch higher in your own country. So over there, you need to see over there, what is the requirement in your workplace? They will tell you very, when you apply categorically, they will tell you, we want you to have a 6.5 in listening, but a 7 in speaking and writing. If your work involves a lot of writing, like if you are a college graduate, your work will involve writing. So definitely it'll be more than 7. They'll ask for you to. So all the 4 skills can have difference depending on the university or depending on the organization where you have applied. The score you need will depend on what you're looking to do in the country, that is work or study. Yes. So what you're looking to do in that country, your score depends on that. Okay. This is the basic test format. As you can see, listening, 4 sections. This information is also available online. And when you do the course with us, we will ensure that you understand this format even better. So listening is of 30 minutes plus 10 minutes transfer time is given. Academic reading, the IELTS has 2 types actually. Suchi ma'am will further throw light on this a little later. There is academic IELTS and there is general IELTS. Okay, listening and speaking remains the same for both. So total time is 2 hours, 55 minutes. Roughly you can say it's a 3-hour test. Okay, and the sections, as you can see, are mentioned over here. 3 sections for reading, 4 sections for listening, 2 tasks in writing and speaking. There are parts. 3 parts are there in speaking. Okay. We now we initiate our discussion with a few FAQs, that is the frequently asked questions. As trainers, as educators, and also as academic counselors, many a times Suchi and me, and now even Karthik, because he's an achiever, IELTS achiever, we even ask these questions. So we have tried to pull in some questions, which I believe will answer your queries. Now, starting with the first question, Suchi ma'am, if you could answer the first question.
Yes, Amrita ma'am, thank you so much. Yeah, we have, these are the very common questions that we are going to handle in the FAQs today. And through that, we are looking at giving you a complete idea of what IELTS is. So the first question that usually we face is the very obvious one, that is, what is the IELTS about and who conducts it, who owns it? I think Amrita ma'am has already outlined it, that IELTS stands for IELTS, International English Language Testing System. And it is jointly owned by the British Council, IDP Australia, and the Cambridge assessment English, the Cambridge, who usually are involved in the in setting the questions. So these three organizations own IELTS. And just because I'm talking about this, I'd also like to mention that British Council and IELTS, IDP IELTS Australia usually conduct the exams in most of the countries. Some countries both are present, in some one of them is there. In India right now, the IELTS exam is conducted by IDP authorities. The next question that I can see here is, which organizations accept IELTS test? Well, IELTS is a test that gives professional and academic mobility to people who want to travel abroad for studies or, you know, to work or to live abroad. And if you ask me what are the organizations or who are the universities or institutions who accept, well, there are more than 11,000 organizations worldwide who recognize IELTS. And there are government authorities, immigration authorities, universities, academic, you know, higher studies institutions, and a lot of companies who accept IELTS as a standard criteria for you to enter into an English speaking country. And there are more than 3,400 institutions only in USA who accept IELTS. Earlier, USA accepted more of TOEFL, but now they accept IELTS. And the third most relevant question, the most relevant question here is, why are there two types of tests? I don't know how many of us here know that IELTS is a test which is divided into two modules, okay? One is academic module, which is usually for people who have applied for higher studies or for higher education, professional degrees in colleges abroad, or professional registration in an English speaking country. So that is usually at the standard of educational English, academic analytical English. Whereas general IELTS module is more for secondary education, some kind of a training, short-term course, or if you want to travel abroad for work, or of course for immigration, for migration to Australia, Canada, New Zealand, or English-speaking countries, you need to take the general IELTS test. So we have academic and general. Academic broadly is for educational purposes, and general is more for migration purposes, work purposes, and for smaller, trainings or smaller courses. Yes, ma'am. Amrita, ma'am?
Yes. Thank you, Suchi, ma'am. Okay. So rightly answered, as she said, yes, there are two types of tests. Okay. Now, the next question also, ma'am, I would like you to highlight this.
Sure, definitely.
If I want to take a test, how do I know which IELTS test should I take?
Yes. Like I just said that IELTS has two modules, academic and general. I have partially answered this. If you would like to go for higher studies, you want to do your master's, you want to do your research work, PhD, or post-graduation, graduation, you have to take the academic IELTS module, which is a slightly higher notch than the general, because it is the authorities consider that academic IELTS, the language level, the proficiency level has to be higher in order for you to be able to understand and grasp the level of education delivered there. And if you would just like to travel abroad for work purposes or for a lesser course, which is not at a university level, then you can go for general. For migration, you need general. American, does IELTS accept American English? This is a very common question that we have faced. Well, my answer to this is yes, because IELTS, like the name suggests, is an international English language test. It is not a British language test or an American English test. So IELTS does accept all the different variations of standard English. It is not necessary that it accepts only, American English. However, if you are writing your answers in American or British English, or if you are speaking in any of the accents, say American or British, both are acceptable. However, what is not acceptable is talking in fake accent. like people here in India, we do not have an American or a British accent. We have more of a neutral accent, which is also called RP. Now, if your regular accent is not anglicized, it is advisable to have a normal neutral accent and give more importance to natural speech, neutral pronunciation, and clarity of speech rather than using an American English. The question here is, does IELTS accept American English? Answer is yes, but it also accepts other standard versions of English pronunciation and standard spellings. And
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
How many skills are tested in IELTS? Ma'am, would you like to answer that?
I think we can ask Karthik because he's just appeared for the test. So Karthik, would you like to highlight how many skills were you tested on?
Yeah, as you may have noticed, IELTS is basically a test which assesses your communication skill level. So in daily life, in academic or industrial settings, there are four sets of skills which we require. So reading, listening, speaking, and writing. These are the four skills that are being tested in IELTS.
Absolutely. Thank you, Karthik. Thank you, Karthik. Next.
I think Karthik will be the best person to answer this question as well. Are all the skills tested on the same day? We'll let Karthik answer this because he's recently experienced this. So Karthik, yes. Would you go ahead?
So when you book the exam, usually you'll be booking the test date for your listening, reading and writing, but the speaking exam may or may not be on the same day. And they will let you know which day the speaking exam will. It will be on a different day.
But can I choose it? Like I can choose my date for speaking
Moment, we don't have the flexibility of choosing due to the pandemic. Otherwise, if it was not the case, we do have the flexibility of choosing which day we give the speaking exam. It will be 7 days before or after the LRW, which is a listening, reading, writing exam.
Okay, that's great. I think my next question will also go to Karthik. Karthik, since we're asking you these questions because you have recently appeared, it's not even a month that you appeared the test and got your results and you actually aced it. So is there a break between the reading and writing test?
Technically, there is no actual break between reading and writing, but you do get a gap when they hand out your paper and collect the paper between the tests, the reading and writing section. Otherwise, you don't have any breaks. You have to be seated at your place and like that.
But do you get a transfer time? Do you get a time to transfer your test answers? 10 minutes?
For the reading section, it is within the time allotted, that is 60 minutes. Okay. And for writing, same, like you have to write while and you don't have an extra time. But for listening, you do have. So it depends. If you go for a computer-based or a paper, pen and paper-based exam, if you go for a paper-based, you'll have 10 minutes extra. But if you go for a computer-based, you don't have that 10 minutes. It's like that.
Right. So Suchi ma'am, Karthik mentioned something about PBT and CBT. Could you please explain it a little further, paper-based and computer-based?
Yes, ma'am, sure. PBT is nothing but paper-based test and CBT is computer-based test. On PBT, usually all the pattern and the examination pattern, duration, etc., everything is the same on paper-based as well as computer-based test. However, on computer-based test, the basic obvious difference is you get your questions on the computer screen. You have the same flexibility of, toggling between questions, toggling between the sections of reading, the sections of writing, whichever you want to do first. The major difference is in writing here, you have to type in the answer. Listening test, let me start with, there are four skills, as we know, listening, reading, writing, and speaking. Listening test, usually what happens is you are given a earphone or a headphone. The test, there is a 30-minute duration of listening test. you hear some audio and you answer the question simultaneously. Now, the difference in PBT and CBT here comes in, where in CBT, that is computer-based test, you are writing the answer simultaneously because you are not allowed any extra time to make your answers fair or to, you know, finalize your answers at the end of the test. Whereas in a PBT, paper-based test, after the listening test is over, you get 10 minutes extra at the end of the test when you can write down your final answers on the paper answer sheet given to you. Similarly, in reading also, reading, however, you don't get any extra time. Only that you have a question paper printed in form in PBT, and in computer-based test, you have the section printed and the questions given on the other side. And speaking, however, there is no difference. The only difference, the major difference in paper-based and computer-based is the listening. That is the last end of listening when you have to transfer the answers. Writing, of course, because you have to type in the answers. Here you have to write the answers manually on paper and pen. And result-wise also, you get the results faster in a PBT version of test. Your results come in 3 to 5 days online, whereas on a paper-based test, your results come a little late than that.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Karthik, can I use a pen in the test? No, these were some questions we received.
Okay. I think this is a confusion that a number of test takers have, because in the website, they say that you should only write with pencil for filling in your details, such as candidate number and such things. But I don't think you have to worry much about it. During the exam, the invigilator will specify what to use when and where. So you have to be careful so that listen to what they say. So you carry a pen, pencil, eraser with you to the exam so that you be ready for anything, whatever they say.
Thank you, Karthik. So yes, Suchi ma'am, I believe last time also we were facing this question a lot. So again, this has come up in our FAQs. What is the difference between IELTS and other international tests like TOEFL, GRE and GMAT? I believe our audience would also have this question in their mind. So could you highlight this, please?
Sure, ma'am, sure. First difference that I'd like to outline here is TOEFL and IELTS are English language proficiency tests. That means they test the level of English and how good you are in your English language or communication. If you have to travel to a foreign land where English is the language of communication. On the other hand, GRE and GMAT are more skill tests or analytical tests where the aspirant or the person who wants to study abroad is assessed on the analytical abilities. And like TOEFL and IELTS only has the English language component, whereas GRE, GMAT, they have the quantitative abilities tested. They also have verbal, quantitative, reasoning skills, a lot of other things that are tested. And GMAT is mostly for business schools. GRE is a graduate record examination. Usually, if you want to go for a graduation program, post-graduation program in a foreign university, many universities will ask you to write down, mostly in USA, of course, this is more accepted. This is mostly a trend in USA if you want to go to. Then you will have to write down a GRE on GMAT. Not all institutions ask for it, but GRE and GMAT are more specified by universities who will give you admissions for graduation and post-graduation. And like I said, it will test all your skills, not only English, but quantitative reasoning, okay? And sometimes also related to this, another question which comes up is, if I have taken a GRE or a GMAT, I have a score for GRE or a GMAT, am I still supposed to take the IELTS? Well, yes, some of the organizations and institutions, they do ask for an IELTS, because IELTS is a language test which qualifies that you will be able to handle the language part in the country when you are in the English speaking country. GRE and GMAT qualify that you have the analytical abilities to be able to take a course at the level of the university where you seek to take admission. and mostly GRE and GMAT are computer based tests. Yes, Amrita ma'am.
Yeah, thank you ma'am. Okay, we now move to our 11th question. What is the pass mark for IELTS? Okay, I would like to answer this question because I have come across this question so many times in the class also. So guys, there is no pass mark. We are so, you know, used to this in our organization or universities. What is the pass mark? Do I have a minimum score? No. There is a band score for IELTS, which is from 0 to 9. Okay. And you have to score the band that is sought by your university to which you are applying, by the organization which you are going to work for. So they decide like what band they are seeking. So that's why to be on a safer side, you must aspire to score a 6.57 plus band. That is to be on the safer side. So there is no pass mark as such. There is no pass mark. We cannot have a pass mark, but there are bands 0 to 9, 6.5 and 7 being the most sought after bands.
We would Ma'am, would you also like to answer the next question that we have? Because this is also a very, very recurrent question. How many times can I take the IELTS test if I don't do well or something? Can I take it again?
Yes, of course. See, that's a great thing that British Council and IDP, they have done is this test is conducted 4 times in a month. So that is 4 into 12. If my calculation is right, it is 48. Am I right, Karthik?
Yep. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you have 48 attempts in a year. If you want to take all the 48 attempts, you can take. So no issues over there. But the thing is that every time you attempt, you have to pay 15,000, rough 15,000 rupees for the test. So it depends on you. So that's the reason there is no limit to the number of attempts and there is no limit to the number of times you can take the test. What mostly students do if they are unprepared, they take a test and they feel that the score is not up to the mark because it would be like they would be missing something by 0.5. So if the university requirement is 6.5, they would have scored somewhere around 5.5 or 6. Then they have to retake the test. So I always believe, and I believe that both Karthik and Suchi ma'am, you would agree with me, it is better to prepare and take the test so that we get a result, we desired band score. It is always better to prepare for it and take the test rather than do a trial and error. So it's like the number of times I take the test into 15K in India. If I take the test twice, I'm shelling out 30,000 over there. Okay. So it is always better that I prepare and take the test. Next question.
You have answered the question, ma'am, in the process.
Yes, I did. But yes. let's ask Karthik, how much did he pay?
Actually, this amount varies each time because of the exchange rate and all. But when I paid, I had to pay 14,700 and it varies according to the exchange rate. Yeah.
Correct. Yes, Karthik is absolutely right. It would vary according to the country also, what GST they're applying and everything, depending on that. So it will vary accordingly. But right now in India, as Karthik said, he paid some 14,700. And as he rightly said, it also depends a little on the exchange rate. If it's okay, I would like to ask Karthik to take this. So Karthik, did you carry?
Yeah, this is a practical question. He was in the situation, so it's good he answers this.
Yes.
So there's one important thing that you have to carry is your ID proof that you used to apply to the exam, which is usually the passport or any such thing like that. And then pen, pencil, eraser. And if you can take a transparent water bottle with you if you want to. Otherwise, everything else is provided over there. Main thing is the passport or the ID that you have to carry. And the other thing is they may ask for a printout or a soft copy of the confirmation that they gave for the test venue and all.
So I think 15 also, if you could answer, Karthik, can you wear a watch during the test? Are you allowed to take a watch?
Other than the things that I mentioned right now, you're not allowed to carry anything. And if you're worried about keeping track of time and all, don't need to worry about it because they will have a clock or any such thing and such thing there so that you can follow it then. So no watch.
Thank you, Karthik. Okay, Suchi ma'am, This question is for you. When will I receive my test results if I have taken the test?
If it's a PBT test, paper-based test, it is they send the results within 13 to 14 days of the day you took your test. And if it is a computer-based test, you receive the results in 3 to 4 days of the date you have taken your test. However, we can ask Karthik, when did he receive his test results?
Yeah, I got it. I went for the paper-based test and I received it in within after 13 days of my LRW, listening, reading, and writing exam.
Yes, I think that's the yes. That's the thing.
I think the next question, Amrita ma'am, we'll ask you, because this is a question in your class you faced a lot of times.
Yes. I did. What if I need to postpone or cancel my IELTS application? Once you have filled in your application and your test date has been assigned, I think 5 weeks prior to it, you can, until then you can cancel and get a full refund. If you cancel it after 5 weeks, like 5 weeks to the exam date, the date of exam has been given to you. If you try to cancel after it, so they will deduct, and you give a reason which is acceptable to them with a medical certificate. So they will, some administrative costs, they would deduct and return the rest of the amount. But if there is no specific reason and you have canceled it at the 11th hour, then there will be no refund. There'll be no refund. So that's the procedure as far as I know. And recently also nothing has changed. So far, nothing has changed.
And what if I lose my the test, the report that I get, the results that I get?
Yes, TRF is what it is called, the test report form. So one per student is eligible for one hard copy of TRF. But just before this session, me and Karthik, we were discussing about this not being sent recently because of the COVID situation. They're not sending the TRF, the hard copy of it. Anyway, the soft copy would be reaching you through mail. But if you lose the hard copy, you have acquired, you have received your hard copy, and if you lose it, you are entitled to 5 more copies, but it will not come to you. You have to give them the name of the university organization where you have applied. You have to inform them, the British Council and IDP. They, in turn, will send it to the organization directly. So it will not come to you. You give the name of the organization and they will send it to them directly. So that is what happens.
Yes. I'd like to add a few more points to that.
Yes.
Actually, when you do apply for the to send a few more copies to different institutes, it depends. Like if you want to send a hard copy, then it may take an additional fees.
Charges. Yes.
If it is a soft copy, it's of no charge. If it is of more than 5, then again they may charge you or something. Mm-hmm. And again, as Amrita ma'am said, right now they're not actually sending the hard copies to your address because of the COVID situation. Otherwise, if you want it, you can go to the center and you can collect it there.
Yes.
And you will get a soft copy of it that is linked with your candidate login that you'll receive. So you can access it over there.
Thank you, Karthik. Next question, Suchi ma'am, it is to you. How soon can I retake the IELTS test?
Yes, actually, I can say Amrita ma'am has kind of answered this. Like she said, there are 4 tests in a month. And even if there is a COVID situation, there will be at least 2 in a month, at least I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. So if you feel you need to retake the test, you can take the next test date available. But however, it's not a good idea. It's better that you prepare and take the test so that you score well. However, for whatever reasons, if you are not able to, you know, score the desired score that you want, you can retake the next available date for the IELTS test.
Yes.
And yes, ma'am, I think you should answer this. If I'm absent, what should I do? And also, if my results, I'm not happy with my results, what can I do?
Very relevant. So yes, Karthik, any idea about it? I think you must have read the clauses when they had asked you to apply for, when you applied for it. Did they give you any specific clause for this?
It was there because they did mention if you were not feeling well or if you show any symptoms or that you're sick.
Right.
They did say that it is better that you don't show up for the exam. because you may risk the other candidates.
Yes, true.
Because the IELTS is always offline exam. You have to go to the center to give it. There is no online version of it.
Right, so now, yes.
Because of that, they do say it, like, but you have to send them an application saying that this was the reason why I was absent and things like that. But I'm not quite sure about the refund policies regarding that right now.
But you have answered partly this question. You have already answered, because in the pandemic situation, they have changed the rules where if you produce that a certificate which states that you had been affected by COVID or any such thing, that you were not well during the test date, then within 5 days to 1 month after the date of the test, okay, they will consider your application, and apart from the administrative charges reduction, you get back the refund. Otherwise, it will not be refunded, but they do give you this margin of 5 days to 1 month. Within that, you should apply for it, okay, and mention that, you know, I was absent for this or that. But if there is no specific reason, or if the reason is not within their acceptance arena, then they will not accept it. I think I'll answer this question also. What if I'm not satisfied with my results? If I'm not satisfied with my results, I can ask them to recheck the particular area, like whether I'm not satisfied with my listening marks. I feel I've done better, you know, or I feel I've done better in the writing, but I've got less mark. I can ask for a recheck, but I will have to pay some amount.
Yes.
For that. They'll state so, which amount.
On the, in the website at your login, once you log in to it, there's a section where it's called EOR, Inquiry on Results.
Yes.
So if you feel as if you did better, or if some section you might have scored more, you can send, mark it to them and say that higher band score in this section. You can apply for it.
Yes.
But I think there is also a certain fees that you have to pay for that.
Yes, yes. True. You have to pay a fees. But in case after the recheck, your scores have increased, this is the best part, you know, that talks about the authenticity of the conducting organization, then they refund the amount. If your score increases after rechecking, then they refund the amount which you have paid for rechecking in case your score increases. Otherwise, they will just recheck and give you your score. They'll let you know what your score is. Okay, Suchi ma'am, my next three questions are for you. If you would answer these three questions again, some of our FAQs.
Okay, sure, ma'am. if I take IELTS test twice, which score can I use? If you have taken the IELTS test within the validity period, that is, each test is valid for 2 years, you can use whichever test has higher score or higher band score. There is no such thing that the latest one has to be given. Whichever is the highest, you can provide that as your final score. And do I lose a point if my answer is wrong? Definitely. The answer can be wrong in two ways, factually or structurally. That means, which is the 24th question as well, spelling. Now, an answer is considered wrong in many ways in IELTS. One, if it doesn't match to the question that is asked. Second, if there is a spelling mistake. Three, and very critical and very tricky, IELTS reading and listening require you to give answers within a word limit. Either they give you a two-word limit or one word, two numbers, or one word, one number. So if that word limit has been crossed, yet your answer is right, you still do not get marks for it. It is considered as a wrong answer. So for each wrong answer, you lose 1 point. There is no negative mark, however. So spelling is also important. So if you go for common words, like if there is a name or an unusual place, it is spelled out. But generally, you don't have spelling mistakes. The words are not very difficult. Reading, of course, everything is given. Listening, you might have spelling mistakes, but then you have to be very careful. Spelling mistake, definitely, you will lose marks. Yes, ma'am. That's perfect.
Yes. So I think all our questions so far has been answered by Suchi ma'am and Karthik, and very effectively we have got to know whatever we were seeking. We will now take up audience questions from here, and then we carry on to this. So I would request Sami sir to allow the audience to ask the questions, put it in the chat box, or they could raise their hands. We can allow the audience to participate.
Is there any doubts just, or any questions?
I'll just interrupt here. Yes, you sir. Have this presentation for IELTS preparatory syllabus, or because once we start a question, sir, we'll stop this presentation and the audience.
It's okay, sir. We can share again. This presentation is about KSOL IELTS course. So when the audience asks us question, that time also we can answer this. Won't be an issue. Yeah.
I'm just enabling this chat box.
Yes,
as
sir.
As well as that is already enabled. People can ask. People can put their questions in chat, or they can raise hands.
Yes, I request the audience, if there are any questions related to today's discussion on IELTS, or if there is any discussion, any queries you have had about IELTS, please put it in the chat box, or you can raise your hand and we'll unmute you and you can ask the question. Yes, unmute and ask. Okay, Deepak has a question.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Deepak.
Yes, ma'am. First of all, I want to ask that can I reschedule my exam date of IELTS? Like, I scheduled my exam date like on 12th, but on 11th or on 7th, I got to know that I will not be able to go on 12th. So I can reschedule the date, or I have to miss that exam?
You will have to see. If it is the 11th hour, Deepak, you will miss the exam. But within 5 days of the test date, you can give them a reason, valid reason, stating why. Send a mail to them, inform them. Then you are going to get a full refund if your reason that you have given them is acceptable. Like in the COVID situation, anything can happen, family issues and health issues and all that. So within 5 days, you have to give them. After 5 days, they may not accept it as much.
No, if it's a family emergency or a very dire emergency, I think they will accept, provided you have to provide the proof.
Yeah, proof
within 5 days of the date you declare. Actually, this before the exam.
In the after what, like if you have the your own login ID and all, there just log in and just find the section where they say if you want to change the date and all, there you would have to give a reason. So check out what are the options for that they give you, that they permit you to change the dates.
Yes.
Otherwise, you would have to do something else.
Yes, ma'am. And one more, ma'am. One more doubt. Yeah, like for those like students who like means for me I'm okay with my speaking, but yes, I'm having some problem while writing. So like these kind of student like me will take like how many months to prepare for this IELTS? Like I'm okay when I'm speaking, but yes, I'm having some trouble while writing. Or
I think Karthik can answer that. He's experienced the training.
So yeah, like I had booked my exam even before I entered the preparatory course at KSOL without knowing what my level is, what I'm capable of. So you have to assess yourself. Like at the course, they had given us a diagnostic when we, the first day itself, so that we know where we stand. So at that time, I found out that I was at 5.5 or 6. Right now, when I got my results, I have a 7.5. You can see the leap over there. So it's all about practice, and you need the specific tips that professionals, like proper trainers, like Amrita ma'am and Shuchi ma'am can give us. Because these are the small, small things that can add a score to our band.
Deepak, during the, suppose you enroll for this course, if you have any specific requirement, like you're doing well in three skills, but you need special help in particular one, you will get that special help. We will give you that special attention so that till you improve or you get your desired score in that particular skill.
Because actually, To be very honest, we all have the knowledge to pass this exam and score really well. But this is a skill-based exam. So we need to tweak that a little bit so that we can achieve what we want.
Deepak, right. Did we answer your question?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Think Arash also wants to ask a question. So Arash, unmute yourself and ask the question, Arash.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Good evening, Dean sir, and the faculties and all the students and classmates that they are here. My question is related to our topic, brother. I was asking what were your target, and did you achieve it or something better than that or less?
He's asking Karthik, I think.
Sorry, could you repeat that once more? I couldn't hear you properly.
Yeah, for sure. I said, what was your target? Like your targeted band?
Target. What was your targeted band?
Okay.
And did you achieve that or not?
So my target was according to the universities that I want to apply to. And on an average, most universities required about 6 or band score of 6. And I'm sure I achieved that because I got a 7.5, and I can apply to almost most of the top good universities across the globe.
Right.
And my second question is, what was your struggles like? What did you struggle while preparing for this test?
So that was basically confidence. Even though both Amrita ma'am and Sochi ma'am had said that my communication was pretty good, but I had to work on my confidence because in the speaking exam, just because of my confidence and how I was not able to put across the information that I want to, like, thinking process is really good, but I need to express it. I have to build up that confidence. So that also was worked upon in this course only.
We also have a question in the chat box by Mubassira Firdos. He asks how to prepare for IELTS. Amrita ma'am, would you like to answer him?
Firdos, first you need to tell us what is the band score you are targeting? Are you targeting for a 6 band score? Are you targeting for a 7 band score? See, as per the British Council, each band score, first we do, in the KSOL IELTS preparatory test, first we find out what is your entry level band score. We conduct a diagnostic. So without any training, what is the score that you can score without us giving you any tips, without us anything? So you want above 6. First, we need to know what is your, you've answered in the chat box, above 6. So anything above 6 will require somewhat training, because this is a skill-based test. So you need tips, you need tricks, you need time, and you need accuracy. Time and accuracy is very important. So within 30 minutes, you get to answer 40 questions. So let's say, you can answer all the 40 questions correctly, provided you get 60 minutes. It does not solve the purpose. Purpose is within 30 minutes, can you score 35 plus? If you can score 35 plus, that means your accuracy level is equivalent to the time given to you. An essay topic is given to you. If you sit for 4 hours, you can write a really world-class level essay. But how does it matter? IELTS is only allowing you 40 minutes to write that test. So your time and accuracy should match within the given time. How accurately can you answer that? First. Second, entry level score and the tips and techniques that we teach you. How effectively are you able to apply? Depending on that, you get your level score. Like Karthik was, there were so many others also whom, so many of them are going to take the test this month. Okay, there is Sushri and Suchi ma'am would know some other, Amprita.
There is Amprita, Sai Shri, Vibhudatta, a lot of people. I mean, they tremendously showed improvement. Yeah. There were some who started at 3.5 in the diagnostic, correct, and they ended at 8.5. In fact, Karthik also ended with 8.5 in the final test that final we gave test. In the course.
Yes.
He ended with 8.5.
But the entry level score sometimes without the training was 3.5. So yes, that means that is an assessment of without the training, your level is 3.5. With the training, when you take the end test, okay, your score in IELTS is almost equal to what we, a prediction that we do. So what we predicted, okay, for these students also, we are anticipating there are another 506 whom we believe will score 7.58. So we're waiting for their results because they're going to take, some of them will take this month, some are going to take next month. So as and when they take, we will apprise you about it.
Excuse me, ma'am. Yes. Excuse me. Is there any student of your current batch who are giving the exam this month? They are present over here. They can share the, how they're preparing. Like Vibhudatta sir, anybody else?
No, I don't think Vibhudatta
sir. I don't see them.
Yeah, I don't see them either, sir.
Okay.
I think Vibhudatta sir was had classes.
No. Sushri has classes too. She is the one who will be appearing this month. So she too has classes, sir. She had informed me that she'll be.
Okay, fine.
Okay, yeah.
Anybody now, else?
Any other questions or queries? I believe we have answered it.
In the chat box, some questions are there.
Yeah,
Anushka is asking, ma'am, I had a question. Should I appear for IELTS to get admission in a law college abroad? Yes, Anushka. If you want to study abroad, you want to pursue your higher education in a foreign English-speaking country, you will need an IELTS score in the academic module of IELTS. Yes, you will need it.
Thank you, ma'am.
To the audience, do we have any other questions from the audience or?
I think, ma'am, we can continue. If there are any other questions, we can take it towards the end.
Yes. So there was some other questions of which the audience, which the students had already asked us. We would continue with some more questions which are left on the slide and then we will be done for today. The last few questions were about the CASEL IELTS preparatory course. So we would like to highlight the IELTS course that we provide at CASEL. First of all, let us give you the clarity that we prepare you for IELTS. Many a times students did ask me, ma'am, this score, what we get in the class, can we show it? No, we are not conducting the official IELTS. British Council is conducting the official IELTS test. We are preparing you for that. Okay, so that you get your desired band score. So who needs this course? Any Indian foreign students, any for whom ESL, English is a second language, English as a second language learner, okay? If your score is below band 5, okay, lagging in at least one skill, you want to score more than 6 band, like Firdosh was asking, you want to score more than 6, Firdosh, you can join us. We'll ensure you get more than 6. The course duration is of 60 hours and mode of delivery is online, okay? It's online. Now comes, this question is to Karthik, I believe. Does it help to prepare in an online preparatory class, Karthik? You can highlight. Yeah,
it definitely does. I can say this without any doubt. Because initially I had no idea where I stand. And after doing the course, the first few classes itself, I knew what were my strengths, what my weakness. It's about discovering yourself. You need to understand yourself, know your strengths and weaknesses so that you can build upon it. So what the trainers, the Amrita ma'am and Suchi ma'am did is that this is a class where both of them were the teacher. It's not as if, so the focus for the individual students that we got was pretty good, because, like more than good, because not everyone has the same kind of requirement. Like some people may need help in speaking, some people in writing, some people in reading. So they were able to give us individual attention and build on it so that we'll be confident enough to do it without worrying about it. And at the end of the day, main thing is confidence. If you don't have the confidence to perform, it will hamper performance. So this is not only for the IELTS, I would say it would also definitely help in your daily life where you need to communicate in a professional or even a general environment. So in that sense, it does help. And again, this question, how are the tests evaluated in the online classes? So when there are three main tests that were conducted, one in the beginning to assess our level, and one in between to see how much we have grown, and one towards the end to see like what is our final capability towards the end of the course. And in between that, we'll have small sets of tests, which will be of specific types that students may find tricky or something that we may need practice to work on. And these kind of tests will help you understand and develop your own tricks, as well as the tricks that the trainers give us.
Yeah, to add to that, the tests evaluated in online class, like he said, there are two levels of evaluations that we do. One is, of course, the diagnostic mid and end, where we start with where you begin. We check your progress in the mid test and we see where you have reached in the end test. Other than that, there are small mini tests given, practice tests given, for which the answers are discussed in the class so that you understand where we have reached. And after the mid test, you get a lot of mock tests, which are timed, for which you are timed. Initially, the tests that you take will not be timed so that you get enough, flexibility to practice the skills and the knowledge shared in the class. After that, we will time the tests. We will ensure that you time your tests, especially for reading and writing, so that you are ready for the final test pattern. So that's how we evaluate the tests. And the scores for writing and speaking are given according to the criteria specified by IELTS band scores.
And the other thing that I want to add on is that I believe that all of us have the knowledge to score really well in this exam, the IELTS exam. But what the trainers, what Amrita ma'am and Suchi ma'am do is that they bring out the skills that we need to score, because having the knowledge is not sufficient, because you need to express it. That is the main point of this exam. So this is where this course will help everyone who wants to have their gateway to different opportunities.
Thank you, Karthik. I think you can carry on with the question number 27 also. Is each student given attention in an online class? So let's hear from the horse's mouth. Karthik has taken this full course online, all 60 hours.
Yes, I think I did answer this partially before. Each student has their own requirements. Everyone's is not equal. Like some may need help in speaking, listening, or reading, or combination of them. So the teachers also willing to give us individual attention. And they're also quite capable of giving individual care, because they have had experience of teaching different kind of people from different background, different capabilities, doctors, nurses, engineers, managers, students, teachers. So since the class is being conducted on the online mode, it has become much easier. It's almost as if we are put on the spotlight, and they get to know what is required from our side.
Thank you, Karthik. Rightly answered. Yes, this question, I would like to answer this question. What if 60 hours are not enough for me? Yeah, that is a very relevant question. This course is of 60 hours. See, at the end of the course, you get to know where do you stand, what is your level, and which we predict a level that you are likely to score in your final IELTS test. If you're not happy with that level, if you want to score further, there are two things. First, you find out which skills are you lagging behind. Which skills? Is it particularly listening and speaking? Then you have to take specific listening and speaking. So we have other courses like communicative English course for that. So you could enroll in another 30 hours of another course, which emphasizes those particular courses, those particular skills. If you feel, listening is fair enough, my speaking is okay, but my writing is not up to the mark. So what do I do? So we're coming up with writing course, specific writing courses also, where you can enroll and take it. It depends on the student's level of performance in a particular skill. If you find that you're lagging behind in a particular skill, then that skill will be hammered and emphasized. You'll get more importance, or you'll have to prepare a little more till you achieve your desired band score in that. Suchi ma'am, can I get help from the trainers even after my course is over in case I haven't appeared for the test? What do you think?
Definitely, definitely, because our work doesn't get over as soon as the classes get over. Till you appear for your test, because it's not like you finish your course today and you write your test tomorrow, not for everyone. So till you write your test, we are there. You can contact us. We'll be in touch with you. You need us to guide you, especially for speaking or writing, to give you more practice. We'll do that. We are there. Till you write your tests, till you get your score, till we know that you've done better than what you wanted to, we are there.
And also, what if I face problems with a particular skill in the test?
We'll give you extra attention for that. We'll make sure that you do well, you get your desired score, not only as an overall score, but in each and every skill that you are going to write for your IELTS exam. So that is our problem. Don't worry. This is for all the students, that if you face particularly problems in particular skill, we'll help you, we'll pull you up. Don't worry about that.
Thank you, ma'am. With that,
I'd like to add one more thing. Actually, I had to give my IELTS exam midway through the course. Even that half of the course itself was really good for me. It was extent where I scored 7.5. So you can imagine if you attend the entire course, it's almost guaranteed that you will go beyond your expectations.
Thank you, Karthik.
Madam, there are 5 questions in the chat box.
Yes, sir.
Just check and answer those questions.
Yeah, yes.
I think, yeah, Firdaus has asked, apart from the test fees, is there any additional fees? Firdaus, when you're applying, so British Council and IDP, they take a test fees for you. That is different. We are a preparatory course. We prepare you for that. So we charge fees as per the number of hours we provide you. Samir sir will give you more information about that. The certificate is, next question, the certificate is valid for the whole life or a period? No, the certificate that you get from IELTS is valid for 2 years. Suppose after 2 years, you have still not got your desired university or your job, then you have to take the test again. And again, the next score that you get will be valid for the next 2 years. It is like that. I think rest of the questions we have answered. So if you are ready for IELTS, then we are ready to help and our admissions are open. And with that, we come to the end of this discussion. Thank you so much, Karthik. Your inputs were really helpful. Thank you, Suchi ma'am, okay, for being supportive. And over to you, Samir sir.
Presentation event, you can talk. In fact, it's been a great experience.
Deepak has raised his hand. Deepak, please unmute yourself and question.
Ma'am, actually, currently I'm in fifth semester. And I'm thinking after my graduation for Germany, so over there IELTS will be needed. So if I take this course now, then since it is valid for only 2 years, I will be appearing for the exam in the fourth year, in the seventh semester. So there will be a gap. Now I will be doing this course and ending of the seventh semester, I will be appearing, or maybe a beginning of the eighth semester. So will it create any, will it be?
Okay.
Because there will be a gap, because now I will do this course and in seventh ending or in eighth beginning, I will be appearing for the exam, since it is only valid for 2 years. So
right. Will you be sitting for your placement, Deepak? Are you going to take your placement training in between?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So as a person who's experienced in handling this particular issue, particularly, what happens is that you cannot prepare if you are too pressurized. Take the preparation course when you have time to understand and apply the strategies, tricks, and whatever is being shared with you, okay? So a lot of things doing together, you need time to process the information being shared with you, okay? And the skills that is being upgraded, you need to apply whatever is being taught in the class. So our advice would be as trainers that you take the, take the preparation when you are not much burdened with your other thing, because in the seventh semester, You'll have your placement training, you'll have your own engineering course, you'll have a lot of tests, and maybe if there is, I mean, God forbid, any back paper or something, that also needs to be cleared. So I believe it is better do it when you have ample time, prepare for it. But to stay in touch, you can practice online, because we share a lot of resources in the class where you can keep on practicing it online even after the training is over. Okay, that you can do. Yes,
but actually the pressure will be same, because now, like now my semester is going on later on after the semester, means after this year, third year, there will be internship, then there I have to spend, and in the last year I will be having the means this
placement,
and also I will be simultaneously applying for the means MS. So it's depend like upon the call letter, what university I'm looking for, if I'll get a call letter or not. So
yes,
that's the thing. So I cannot say that I want to do MS, so I won't be sitting for a job, since it is depend.
Yes, like, yes, absolutely. You should not be like, saying that also. Yes.
So how you should like handle it? Like I should take this course now or like later on?
I'll just take a call to the question that you have asked. You've been interacting. Madam, with your permission.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead. You don't need
I think, Deepak, it's like if you start, you take up the course, get yourself prepared, get to know the skill sets which are required, and all that knowledge get acquired with the process of time. As Madam was rightly saying, it is not that you take up a course and you are done with the strategy to appear for the test. You know, it needs a bit of a preparedness. It could be that you can touch into 7 bandwidth by a certain date. It could exceed to 9. You never know. So if you have a preparedness before time and you can strategize for sitting for the test sometime later, it will equip you with those of the skill sets, you know. Like for instance, let's say you are playing badminton. You have to get to know the skill to, play the shuttle to the opponent, right? So that requires a time span, you know? I would ask you to, if you are ready, you can sit for the, get yourself admitted, get yourself prepared, then it might not require another test, preparatory classes later on. You can keep in touch with me. So yes. It is said, things become tough gets going. So if you don't have much of a time, always time is a constant with everybody. You being a good student, you might prepare, start doing it, and you can, with toughness of things, you can go ahead. So agile to the fragile times, they say.
Right, so, sir.
Fragile. Go ahead.
And adding to what sir is saying, what sir is absolutely right, adding to that, you will see this is going to up your level of English, which is even better for your placements. You'll have your GDPI, you'll have your interview, GDPI.
Yes, yes.
Okay, and also writing skills are also there. And IELTS is an advanced level course, which is giving you that added advantage for your placements. So I believe it is beneficial if you take it now when you have enough time in your hands. Okay?
I agree completely.
When you start preparing, I started preparing just in the last minute, to be very honest. But if you do have sufficient time to prepare, I think you would achieve a higher score.
Yes.
And as ma'am did say, it will help in other aspects of life other than the IELTS as well. Because if you are also considering placements, you will have interviews, you will have to interact with people. There, it is very important to up your communication level.
True. Abhik, you have raised your hand. Please unmute and ask your question.
Yeah, I am a student of School of Biotech, KIT itself.
Yes.
So currently in my fourth year, I still have 1.5 year almost yet to complete, currently in my seventh semester. One quick question to Karthik. What kind of questions are asked, or what kind of discussion is carried out when you're in the speaking part of your IELTS examination?
So speaking exam, to be very honest, it's nothing out of the ordinary. They focus on our daily life kind of aspect. So it won't be as if they will ask you a technical question, which you may or may not know. It's about like, what do you do as a hobby, or what kind of things?
but you should the thing that they're expecting out of you is how smoothly, how fluently you express your thought process, and how you connect the ideas properly. So it's that thing they focus on. It's not about the technicality or the those kind of things. It's more about how you put your idea across. So it's very, I would say the exam itself was quite entertaining when I took it, because it talks, you can answer it in a very personal level. You can express what you feel like. So it's like that.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Karthik. And one small question to ma'am, to the panelists, that right now the end semesters are approaching, so I'm a bit hesitant to start with the course, though I have a lot of time because I'll be directly in School of Biotech. As many might know, we have a BTech MTech integrated course, so as I'll be completing my MTech itself and I'll be applying for my PhD, so for that there's a lot of time. But right now the end sems for the seventh semester are approaching. Do we have any possibilities of this course start of the next session of this course starting somewhere in early January? Is there a possibility for this course to happen in early Jan? Because then start of the semester, it's rather easier to give proper time, because it helps to concentrate well on the course and prepare myself.
Yes, Abhik. See, this is a quarterly thing. We have it in every quarter. I mean, we roll out this course of 60 hours in every quarter. So 4 times in a year, we do it. So we have the next quarter IELTS preparatory course from January. Okay. But then it is like first come, first serve basis. Okay. So we have a required number of seats. Once they are fulfilled, we will not take further admissions. So yes, Abhik, but it is there. It is there.
As a student, I don't think it will be much of a problem, because I also had my mid-sem exams towards the end of the IELTS program, but it didn't really hamper my preparation for either of them. So I think it's totally up to you, and but I do think it won't be a problem.
All right, Karthik. Thanks a lot for the tip. Thanks. Thank you.
Any other questions, ma'am? You'd like to take? There's some chat box. Some questions are there.
I think we've taken the questions. Is there any new question? We have taken the question, sir.
Okay, fine. Then we can wind up the session.
Yes, sir. Sami, sir, it's over to you now.
Okay, fine. Can you remove this so that we can just wind up the session. Thank you very much. It's been a very enriching and informative session. In fact, we are very happy to see such a questions. The students are so much interested to know various aspects of IELTS. It's like knowing every bit in one session, though it's not possible, but still we tried and ensure that you listen from the horse's mouth and also from the teacher's mouth. So it's been a very informative session, and I'm very much grateful to both our trainers who have been working hard over the last 3 months to ensure all the trainees to get a personal touch and preparedness for cracking the toughest exam. And in fact, Karthik is the result of the hard work which our trainers put, and you have heard from Karthik, and we will soon have more faces like Karthik coming in the next session.
Yes, more to join Karthik in the spotlight coming soon, kind of.
So we'll have in next session, we'll have more faces like Karthik from different schools. Like he's from mechanical, there will be people from yoga, from law, from various schools. They can put forth their perspective about how they prepared and how this coaching helped. And it's an ongoing process. We will conduct it every 3 months, and gradually our students, our success will speak out, our work will speak. And later on, we need not have to speak, our results will speak out, and students will approach us. That is what our firm conviction. Because of the quality training we are providing, it's in fact you won't find anywhere in the city with such a affordable price. You are getting the best trainers and who are devoted to you with the world-class training. That's a kind of a personal effort, personalized effort they put. So we are charging the fees of 10,000, which is very huge, comparative. In fact, it's less than the amount which you have to pay for the exam. So once you spend 10,000, you do not have to pay again for the preparatory course. With one attempt, you will have the 2 years kind of you will be having the 2 years visa, I can say, with this IELTS scorecard. You can approach any universities and of your choice. It's better to get enrolled, get yourself coached, and then appear for the exam so that your 15,000 won't go waste. And you will at one go will have the sufficient band score, which will help you for next 2 years. So thank you, Dr. Biswajit Das, our dean. In fact, we will be just winding up the session. There is a person raising hand. Would you like to
say something? Yes, sir. Just a small query to the trainers. I wanted to know, because PhD for my requirement of IELTS, I have to go for my PhD, and PhD is something that normally carries out for like 4 to 5 years sometimes. So as you said that this score is valid for 2 years. So if I go there and complete my 2 years of PhD, after the 2 years, do I need to give the IELTS examination again in a foreign country while I'm carrying out my PhD?
No, Abhik. It is required for your entry.
For your admission purpose only. So once you're enrolled to the program in the universities, it's not required after that.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
So then I'm just ending the session. Thank you, Dean Sir, for your precious time. Thank you, trainers. Thank you, Karthik, for joining us. This has been a very special session, though it prolonged for 1.5 hours. But we got very enriching questions, very diverse questions. And thanks for answering all those questions. I hope all the students have got their replies satisfactorily. So thank you very much. I will formally end up this session. And